and get up to the front of the queue. And the lady, I said to the lady, three sausage rolls. And she says, it's the same price for four, I'll give you four. And she hands up the four. I don't really want the four. I don't really even want one. But I said, fine. I order a coffee. The coffee's not bad in there. I take it all out. It's cost £2 bonus. Take it out. Outside, I'm with the boys. And they're running around. I've got all their paraphernalia and all the stuff for the day out. And the coffee as well. And I give them their sausage rolls. I've got this extra sausage roll, this number four sausage roll. Quite hot and greasy in my hand. I see a guy begging in the street. I think, I'll give it to that guy. That guy could want this. There's a guy begging in the street. He could want this sausage roll, you know. He's begging there. I've got something here. I've got the sausage roll. It's hot. It's warm. It's not that healthy, but if you are hungry and you're sitting on the street, you may just be glad of a wee sausage roll. There's a lot of people walking past this guy, and I think this is going to be a difficult interaction here. So it could go either way. It could be very embarrassing. He might be embarrassed. I might be embarrassed. I'm not sure. Or he might be glad of it, and it might be just great. It might all go really great. This could go great. But I'll let all this crowd pass first. So the crowd, I walk up slowly past the guy begging on the street. The crowd come past me, and then I go over subtly to the guy and say, would you like this sausage roll? And he says, nah, nah. That's a nah. That's a total nah. So he's just like blanked it. He's just pushed it all away. So I don't hang around. I just go, fine. Move on my way. Now, it didn't go well, but I was fine with the whole thing. He seemed fine, I was fine, didn't want it, okay, on we go. So I'm eating my sausage roll, I don't even want mine. This like greasy, jelly, dog foody sausage roll. I throw my half a sausage roll in the bin. I've got this other one now, the fourth that has been refused, the neglected sausage roll. What am I going to do with it? It goes in the bin as well. And I asked the boys, how are you getting on with your sausage rolls? And they're like, we love these. They love them. Of course they love them. So that's fine. They've had their fruit. It's all balancing out. Everything's okay. Now, I've got the sausage roll conundrum to ponder for the rest of the day. I'm in charge of the two lads and we're going on to another park and we're going to go to the museum. So I've got that conundrum to ponder now. So, like, I didn't want the sausage roll, really, but it was cheap, so that's why I bought it. And the guy on the street, he didn't want it either, so, you know, you can't. But I had made lots of judgments about this guy on the street. He was a local guy, and I'd made lots of judgments about why he wouldn't want it. Like, he wasn't hungry enough to want that, so obviously he had made judgments about why he was there and begging, and maybe he actually lived somewhere close by. So I was guilty of all sorts of prejudices, judgments, and probably light hypocrisy in many different levels. So I was going through this, and the fact that he was local, I brought that up to headline all of my thoughts and judgments and prejudices. And so I went through this all day. And then, you know, maybe, as I was thinking, maybe the guy was vegan. You know, maybe he was vegan. Maybe he was, you know, maybe he just didn't eat meat. Maybe that was the reason that he didn't want the sausage roll. But who would want it? And as I was mulling over it, all of these judgments and prejudices and classifications and hypocrisies were bubbling up. It had brought out, it had just extracted all of that out of the background of my thinking. That was slightly alarming, though, was making all of these very, very light, all very light, nothing major, nothing. No headliners, but all just light prejudices in the background there. The thing was, I didn't give him a coffee because the coffee had value to me. I didn't give him anything that was of value to me. I didn't give him the tenner out of my wallet. That's of value to me. I wasn't going to put myself out for this guy, but I had something that I was going to throw in the bin. It was more or less rubbish. The sausage roll, let's be honest, the sausage roll is rubbish. It's a rubbish sausage roll. And that's the crux of it. I was giving away a rubbish sausage roll. That's the main crux of the whole thing there, really. And I wasn't giving him a fantastic, high-value sausage roll. Anything of great, great value. I wasn't handing any of that over. That's the real crux of it for me. So I've sort of exposed myself there, an area of selfishness. That's what it is. That's what the conundrum kind of exposes. It doesn't expose a man who is giving over to help his fellow man, is helping another fellow man there. It exposes a gesture of selfishness. The sausage roll conundrum is a gesture of selfishness, really. And then there's the guy on the street. His gesture is one of to be applauded. I would applaud what he has done there. He has said, no, I don't want that gesture of selfishness, that rubbishness. I don't want your rubbish. He doesn't want my rubbish. I threw it in the bin. I threw my own in the bin. So that's to be, that's, you know, I've learned something there about myself. The next day, I'm at Lidl with the boys again. I'm in charge of the boys again, 2 days in a row. Fine, all fine. And what has happened is, this next day, is that I've been at a screening of The Jungle Book. And during The Jungle Book, I'm eating the boys' popcorn. And one of my fillings has popped, and I've felt it. And it's like, oh shit, the filling's gone. Filling's gone. And later in the day, I've become slightly depressed about this because I've let my dental appointment slip, and I'm going to have to phone them up, and it's going to be like, oh yeah, I haven't been there in a year and a half. And so there's that, and it's like, oh no, I'm going to have to go through all of that. And I decide what I'll do is I'll go to Lidl and we'll top up what we've had with a few cheap croissants, you know. So we're in this situation again now, and a second day and another pastry drama here. I've got four this time. I've bought four croissants. I've thought it all through, and I'll go up to the counter, and I've paid for the four and a few other things, because you always buy lots of other things. And it's a guy, and the guy goes, you get five for cheaper than four. This is what he says to me. So I'm going to put you through five. I'm going to put through five through the till, so you get it for cheaper. Now, in my mind, I'm thinking, I kind of want that fifth one. These croissants are quite nice, but I don't want to eat too many of them. I don't want to eat like two or three croissants here in one day. So I'm thinking this through, and I'm thinking, he's charging me for five. I should have five, but he's doing me a favor. He's actually charging me for five, but that means he's charging me less, but it's still the principle of five and I'm getting four. So I'm going through the principle of five and four. I'm only getting four. What am I receiving? So this is bringing up more selfishness in me. This is exposing more selfishness. This is what this is doing. This is exposing me to my own selfish ways. So I'm thinking all of this, and I'm thinking, and yesterday there was the sausage roll conundrum. Today there's the croissant conundrum. So the sausage roll conundrum's there. I'm just going, and I've missed the moment where I can say to the guy, look, I'll just go and get a fifth one then. I've missed the moment. And I've got a sore tooth, and I've got this this situation drama coming up now with having to go and to get in touch with the dentist that I've neglected, a neglected dental relationship. So I've got this drama, the croissant drama now, the sausage roll conundrum, croissant drama. And I just go, yeah, that's fine, I pay for it. I'm outside Lidl with the two boys eating more low-priced flaky pastry, just trying to process it all. Trying to process all of this. Like, it's all now. It's all hit me now. It's hit me now. And I'm there, and I'm like, is this what a father should be doing, really? Just day after day, eating flaky, low-priced, greasy pastry with his son. Like, different types, you know, like, you know, savoury and sweet. Every day after day, savoury, sweet, low-priced, flaky, greasy pastry. They seem to be enjoying it. And it's a sliding scale of pastry. That's what it is. Living in a sliding scale of trying to trying to achieve as little expenditure as possible when you're out. You know, when you're out and about, you have to spend. When you're in, you can stay still and not spend. When you're out, you're spending. What are you spending on? Let's try and achieve as little expenditure as possible through the different variations of pastry. That's what it is. That's the general crux of the story. It's when you're in, you can eat healthily. You can maybe bring fruit out in a Tupperware box. Who's going to eat that? And then you're out, you've got to spend things to be out. When you are out, you need to spend because you're out, you're moving. When you're in transit, you are spending. That's a rule. What are you spending on? You can spend on something that is non-pastry, which is going to cost you money, or you can spend on pastry, which is going to save you some money, but it's going to cost you health-wise. What are you going to do? Well, it depends on your circumstance. But, you know, it's mostly pastry. It's mostly traveling in transit with pastry. Traveling through the layers of pastry as you're in transit and in the world. Being in the world with pastry, the different variations, textures, saturations of pastry. That's what it is. The flakiness, the dryness, the greasiness. Flaky, sweet, savory pastries in the world, traveling through it, moving through it, ingesting. Where is the napkins? Where are the napkins? They don't give you napkins. Where are the napkins? Wipe it in your trousers. Wipe the grease in your trousers. What about the jelly, the jelly meat? What are we going to do with the jelly meat? Throw it in the bin. It's rubbish. What are we eating? We're eating rubbish. Why are we eating rubbish? We're outside. We're trying to save a bit of money. What should we do? Go home and eat some fruit and some and vegetables. What are we doing outside? Eating pastries. That's it. That's it. That's it all. That's all. That's it. That sums it up. That sums up the conundrum and the drama. When I go into a shop and I'm buying sausage rolls or croissants, I say 4 5. And that bamboozles them. 4 5. I don't want an extra one. You don't want an extra one. Throw it in the bin. Throw all of them in the bin. Throw it all in the bin. Throw everything in the bin. Don't offer it to anyone because you're only revealing yourself as being selfish and greedy and a gorb. And a gorb. GORB. It's greedy. Greed. It's greed. It's pastry greed. That's what it is. That's what I'm trying to get at. I'm trying to get at pastry greed. That's what it is. Pastry greed. Money greed, pastry greed, both. And it's a sliding scale of pastry and not a care in the world for fellow man.